and on Nairn. I had to return something. The Longchamp, the fake one I got, the zipper was all screwed up, so it was not even worth it. Not for that price anyway. Anyway, I got this Coach Authentic wallet. Love it. It's like their classic monogram style. We're just gonna check what they have behind the counter. Like the glass case, and then we're gonna go look at the personal care area. See if they have anything. I don't see anything here. Nothing that we want. Value Village. Oh, I love the staff here. They're so nice and friendly. I mean, at other Value Villages too. So we exchanged at Longchamp. I was like, yeah, I have a video of me recording it in case you think I changed the price or changed the tags. Because, you know, some people, like, if they buy shit, right, they'll be like, you know, like, they'll take the tag off and give another bag and say that tag was for that bag, you know? So I understand, like, you know, they have protocols, but they know me here. I'm always here, and I bought a lot of shit from here. So, they're just really, like, pleasant to deal with, and sometimes you don't get that when it comes to other Value Villages. Like, the only other Value Villages I'm really well known at is this Value Village, the Pembina one, the one by my house, Jefferson, well, actually all of them except for Unicity, because I don't really go to the Unicity location that often. Anyway, we're going to go to Plato's and see if they have that Michael Kors wallet, see if we can flip that. Thank you, Value Village, for a great, pleasant experience. Oh, look at that, buy 20% off. Yeah. It is the same place. Oh, it's huge. I get it, but I'm still gonna look around. Thank you. Just anything there. Okay, it is a little bit pricey at $175, but it's in like excellent condition. It is a Hamilton, so I don't know. I'm really kind of confused if we want to get it. Kids Bay. What? Why would they have this here? Maybe. Let me get it. Do you want it? The only thing is it doesn't have its long strap. But we might have one at home, so maybe we'll just add one. I'm getting a little bit nervous. Oh wait, okay, I'm getting nervous because it's like, I'm finding all these bags I want to buy, but at the same time, do I want to keep them? Do I want to sell them? And most importantly, like, I'm going on my trip. I should be saving money instead of buying all these bags. You know what I mean? Okay, let's look under here. But there's like a black bag, so I mean, it was, that Kate Spade for 80 is just like a deal and a half. Like, you can't beat that. I just want to be rich, okay? Like, that's my goal. And people might think that there's more to life than that, which there is, don't get me wrong. But that's what I want for myself, you know? I want to be financially stable and do anything I want, whenever I want, without worrying about that kind of stuff, you know? And of course, live the life of 30, you know. Live the life of luxury and all that stuff. Here's that MK. Yeah, this one's 80. Not worth it. This is hella cute. It's brand new. 25. It's actually a good deal. But I don't know about the color. Best to not risk it. But for 25, I don't know. Isn't this Kate Spade bag hella cute? Like, look at it. Right? The interior is actually pretty clean. Minimal layering on the corners. And I think we can find a strap to go along with it. I think. Let's see. Okay, guys. I think that is all we're gonna get. I think we'll look and see what else. See, there's the other MK that I was talking to you guys about. That one. Let's look at the wallets and see if they have anything. Maybe they have some Kate Spade wallets. Actually, they would probably post that on Instagram if they had one. There's like hardly anywhere on this actually. And not even that much scuffing on the plate. Yeah, this is totally worth it.
Hi. How are you today?
Good, how are you?
Okay. Mom, do you know why this is priced as is? It is lowered, right?
Is it missing the... I think it's missing its long strap.
Oh, that's why. Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought it was too modest.
Oh, yeah. Some people don't care, but we just priced it a little lower for that reason.
Sorry, what?
Oh, that's...
It's okay. Okay, so that's what we got today. So exciting. Thank you. You too. Thank you, you too.
Okay, we will grab your cash and I'll bring your bag. So let's go to the side.
Okay. Okay.
Let me see which one. Oh, I see it already. Sorry, it's just on the side here.
Good to see you from Amanda.
This is really cute, actually. Ooh, so exciting. Okay, I got this bag because it has a navy trim. It's very kind of like aquatic and nautical. And like there's no scratches on it. It's actually, oh, well, there's a little bit of whatever that is, but we can like totally remove that. Anyway, guys, that's what we got from Plato's. Thank you, Plato's. I only paid $230, I think. We got a good deal, I think. Hey guys, it's Miss Philly. I just wanted to show you guys what I got in the mail today. Well, yesterday. I did kind of an unboxing on my Instagram story. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, the link will be on the down bar. But yeah, so let's get right into it. So this is a bag that I got. It's the Louis Vuitton Montsouris backpack. I believe it's in the PM size. Could be in the MM, but I think it's PM, or maybe I'm just big and it seems like a PM to me. I bought this pre-loved from a consignment store in the US, in Florida, from my Instagram. And I've been following her for a while and I know she only sells authentic stuff. So I'm not going to get this authenticated because I know it's real. She's a reputable dealer. And I mean, I can tell it's real just by looking at it and feeling it. Louis Vuitton Montsouris, and it's in actually really good condition. It's for being pre-loved. I think this is a 2002 bag based on the date code. So I chose this in the Dernier Event because of, I know that the Montsouris backpack always gets hella stains on here and it looks ratchet AF. Like completely ratchet. Like it's a bum bag, and you know, and I'm not into that. I hate when the vachetta, whatever, the leather gets stained. I do not like that. I'm very anal when it comes to that. So the fact that the handles are all like that, treated, colored, coated leather, it prevents it from staining, although one big thing is that it does crack easier. And there are some cracking on the handle, like right there, see? It's not a huge, huge, huge big deal. I mean, I wouldn't even know how to replace that if it eventually cracks all the way through. But I know, but I mean, like, it's usually just a top layer that's cracked. It doesn't, like, usually go all the way through unless you're really, really tough with your bag. Anyway, it has that brass handle thingy right here. It has a Louis Vuitton right there. Yeah. So I really like this bag. Well, when I got it, when I saw it on her Instagram account, I was like, damn, boom, bought it sight unseen. Well, I saw it, didn't know what the size was, didn't know what the condition was, other than she said it was in excellent condition. But I have learned now that I should really inquire about condition. The thing is, though, when you're buying pre-loved and you're competing with other people, people snatch it up really quickly. So if you like an item, usually that's how you have to go, is snatch it up or reserve it right away. You know, I didn't really want to ask any more questions after, because it's like, we already agreed to buy it. Like, I already agreed to buy it. So why am I going to ask questions after, you know? So if you're going to buy pre-loved, make sure, you know, say claim or I want it, but I have some questions to ask, because you really want to know what you're getting and not be surprised like I was. Like, it's not a big deal to me, but it's still, you know, it could be problematic to other people. So the main problem of this bag is the fact that you have to unbuckle it like a belt buckle all the time you want to get into it. That's the number one problem of this bag. It's very reminiscent to the, what's that crossbody bag from Louis Vuitton? I forgot. Anyway, you go like this, the flap is open, there's a stain here, not a big deal. And then you do the drawstring like this. And then you open the bag as so. And it's just basically a canvas lining with one slit pocket like the Speedy. There's a thing right here, and then the date code is somewhere there. The date code is right there. I don't know if you can see that. Now, the lining does come out. And what I didn't know about the bag was there's like a lot of ink stains inside the bag and pen marks. So, like that. See, actually it was worse. I used some Palmolive and laundry detergent to get the stains out. It was worse than this. Like, it was big blots of black or blue ink. I was a little bit like, yeah, you know. But I got most of it out, kind of. Like, they're still darkening, but it's not as worse as it was, so it's not that much of a big deal to me. Plus the fact it's an interior, plus the fact that it's not like a disgusting stain like food or blood or something like that. It was a pen, so it's not like, oh, you know. And there's more pen marks like right here, here and there. So it's not a big deal to me anyway. It might be a big deal to you, but whatever. Now, if you're like a big bitch like me, this is not going to work for you as a backpack. I'm like, I don't know what I weigh now, 290, 300, who knows, but I'm around there and I'm 5'10 and a half, almost 5'11. This does not look cute on me as a backpack. If you are a skinny bitch, tall or short, this will work for you. Even like if you were average size, this would work for you. But if you're big and tall, it looks weird on your body. Like, it looks freaking weird on me. I would need to be like 180 maximum to have this bag. I mean, looks and, you know, view and perception is subjective. This is just my opinion. You could think something differently, but to me, it looks weird as f*** on me, okay? I will be using this as a crossbody bag. And I was kind of fiddling around with it. I'm like, what? There's a straps. Maybe I'll just attach the crossbody on here, but it looks like kind of tapered and weird. So what I decided to do, which actually makes it so much better, is these are the straps. Go on and unstrap your strap. God, that sounds perverse. Like a strap on. Okay, so unstrap your strap like this on both sides. Be careful that this doesn't fall off, because it tends to fall out and I lost it for a good hour. So, can strap your straps. And then you want to loop it together. So basically, this will loop under, this will loop over here. So this would go like these two straps. This would loop into this loop here. And then you loop it into the belt buckle and then buckle it off. I'm not sure if anybody else on YouTube has done this, but I figured this out on my own, so it's not like I Googled it. And then the other side, the underside, you do the exact same thing. You loop it in this little leather piece that holds it, and then loop it into the belt buckle, as so. And that turns it into a crossbody bag. And it hangs nicely because it's not like all tapered here on the side. So that's what it looks like. I'm going to actually model it for you. Okay, I hope you got the gist of it of what it looks like. Yeah, so I'm gonna be wearing it like that. Yeah. And I actually kind of like that look. It looks kind of chic to me that way. I mean, if you're shorter, it might fall a little bit lower and look kind of cuter. But right now, that's, or I could just put it like shoulder bag instead of crossbody. But I mean, it's in really good condition. I mean, I paid 500 US. And after duties, customs, shipping, conversion to Canadian dollars, I basically paid like 630 Canadian dollars, which in retrospect is a little bit expensive for this, but this is pre-loved. It's in great condition. It's discontinued. I mean, you can't buy this backpack anymore unless you buy the newer model, which would run you like $1,800, or the Palm Springs, which would, you know, is even more than that. So I think it was a good deal. I mean, if you just keep it at US dollars, it sounds nice. 500 for Louis Vuitton, hello, you know. But I think it looks chic. I like the print. I've never owned the Damier et Ben. I've only always owned the monogram. So I mean, that's it. I mean, I like it. The bottom pocket here can't really fit anything. It is so tiny and kind of hard to always kind of, you have to dig in for the zipper, and you can't fit really anything in there except maybe some cards and cash. You can't even fit a phone. You can't even fit an iPhone. I think an iPhone 4 might fit in there. Yeah, that's exactly the size of an iPhone 4. You can't fit a 5. Maybe you could shove it in there, but a 6, 6 plus, hells to the no. 7 plus, no, you can't fit that in there. So yeah, that's my Damier et Ben from Louis Vuitton, Mon Souris, and I like it. I'm actually going to bring it to the leather specialist right now after this video, and I'm going to ask him to unsew that and then keep that part together and then put on a magnetic closure on it like this. I brought this bag to show him what I want it to look like. I want like that kind of magnetic closure on it, so it's just easier to get in and out, because I don't have time to keep unbuckling this, okay? That's why I sold my other crossbody from Louis Vuitton. It was just such Samour, whatever. I just kept having to unbuckle. And you know, if this pocket was bigger, then yeah, I could put my phone, my wallet in there, but it's not. There's no easy access except for that pocket. And even then, that pocket isn't that easy of access to. So, that is that. but yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I mean, I don't see a Damier et Ben in a, I think this is an MM actually. I don't think it's the PM. I just think that I'm big. Anyway, we'll just say it's an MM. I think it's an MM. If I'm wrong, please correct me. The Damier et Ben, Louis Vuitton Damier et Ben Mon Souris in an MM. There is no videos on YouTube on it. There's one that's a GM, and then the rest were the monogram. So I believe in this print, in this model, it only came from what I understand from the other video that I watched as a special order or as a limited edition. So it usually only came in the monogram, and then this would be like a special order or limited edition that came out. Anyway, I hope you guys like this video. yeah, there's no thrifting today. This is just going to be a review on this. And then my other bags I'm going to bring to the leather specialist. And then we're going to go to the leather specialist and get this hopefully rectified. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And you'll see Miss Philly rocking a Louis Vuitton, okay? I heard from somewhere that the canvas of a Louis Vuitton is exactly the same canvas used for Michael Kors. And if you follow me on Instagram, you saw me mention that there is no difference. Feel a freaking Hamilton. Feel a Louis Vuitton canvas. It feels freaking the same. Even if you, my fake Louis Vuitton makeup bag pouch, granted it's a little bit like dull, or shiny. Was it shiny or dull? One or the other. Aside from that, it feels exactly the same. Like, to be honest, like, TBH, capitalized. There's no difference. Honestly, you're paying for the name. You're basically paying for the name. Like, yeah, there's quality. Yeah, there's, you know, history of the brand. But when it comes to materials, okay, you're paying for the name. Like, honestly, like, you know, things get scuffed and stuff. Like, look at this. There's, like, some wear on the bottom, like spotting. There's cracking of the handles. Louis Vuitton cracks, okay? It's not Asian or black. Louis Vuitton cracks. Someone's gonna say I'm racist. What I meant by that is black people and Asian people age better. No offense, but we do. And Spanish people. Which is funny because I was watching Ugly Betty last night and I was like, wow, Selma Hayek looks so good in this. She's like, in like, what was she back in 2006? 30? 20? No! She was 40 and she looked like she was freaking 28. Yeah. I like it. Like, there's Louis Vuitton right there. Yeah, so we're... Okay, I see one more scuff, like, right here. Like, right there. But yeah, I mean, I'm not really anal about it because it's pre-loved and I paid significantly less than I would if I were to buy it brand new. So, I ain't even worry about it. So, we're gonna rock it. Rock it like it's new to me, because it is new to me. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Okay, guys, I also wanted to mention there was, like, lifting here, and I want to get that fixed, too, at the leather place. I'm assuming they're just going to glue it down or use some sort of adhesive. Yeah. Aside from that, that was the only problem with it. That, the staining inside, and a little bit of cracking on the handles, which is not even that noticeable. Where is it? I'll show you. Right there. It's just almost like a surface kind of cracking, see? It's not completely thrown. There's like multiple layers. So I don't know if they can do anything about that, if they can go over it or what, but yeah. Eventually that's gonna give, I suppose, but I wouldn't even know what to do when that happens. I guess Louis Vuitton can replace it, but I mean, I don't have a receipt, and usually Louis Vuitton only, I don't know if they replace straps without a receipt. I don't know, but yeah. So, there's a logo there. Louis Vuitton there. Scuff there. A little bit of white spots there. Not a big deal. The front. Let's go back inside and... There's the canvas, the leather strap, and the interior. See, when you just hold it like that, the staining isn't as noticeable. You'd have to kind of flip the lining inside out, and then there's the date code there. I think that means zero, so May 2002. I think that's how you read that, and this is made in France because it's SP. So, yeah. I think that's how you read the code. Anyway, yeah. Thank you, guys. Okay, guys. It's gloomy AF, and it's spewing liquid. We're just going to stop by the, well, by a village, because... You don't want to miss out on shit, basically. I mean, it's on the way. I'm out. Might as well. It's actually a really good price for this. I mean, and it's a size 6, so it's not like a skinny bitch size. And it looks like to be like limited edition. What I love is that the tag is still on. Usually people remove the tag. You want to check the French on the back, make sure all those apostrophes are there, because sometimes the fake ones forget to put that on there. So I think we're gonna get this. It's really cute. Hi, Nancy.
I'm here. You left already.
No, I'm leaving on
tomorrow.
Monday. Yeah, I
not
changed
this week?
It. No.
Thursday.
I was supposed to call on Thursday. What'd you find? Ooh.
$12.99. It's
not bad.
Backpack.
It's cute.
Neil Wong don't hate.
Neil Wong don't hate. This is pretty good for this. $27.99 minus 30%, and the tag's still on. Size 6.
Ooh, you can resell
it. Yeah.
Hopefully, I could fit in it. I'm not that skinny.
One day.
Fossil too. Oh, they
price
it
$40. $40. Fossil doesn't sell for me. Although it's a nice style and color.
Let's see.
Yeah.
It looks funny.
No, actually, it looks cute.
Okay, let's go to school.
You look like a teen girl. Ooh, Tallulah. Just walking, I saw this. Cashmere, damn. That's some fancy ass shizzle. Isn't Tallulah, I am made with cashmere. I'm soft and warm. Cuddle me, yay! There is some bougie shit. Long shot, that's the only one.
It's the only man.
I don't know how to say that, eh?
Does it say long shot though?
Yeah, it does, but it's broken. I bought it and I returned it because the zipper is broken. I think we're gonna get this Tokidoki with sports sack. It's in excellent condition. And there's like lots of compartments inside. So I think we're gonna get it. And we want you to do a bag rehab on this Marc Jacobs. Someone took the plaque off and it's been like used to death. Look at that. Look at the interior. And then Marc by Marc Jacobs. It's real, but it's just toe up from the flow up. Why are you obsessed with Victoria's Secret lately?
I don't know. I told in my...
It's a nice color though.
It's a Philippine snack. I put something in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I'll give my cousins.
Oh, yeah, you're
girls.
Going. I forgot. You're going.
It's $6.99
for these. Minus 30%.
Six.
Does it look expensive? They priced it at $12.99. Who is it? Who's the designer? We want to know.
It's Daniel Leather.
Well, it's kind of expensive. It's cute, but Daniel Leather doesn't sell for me that much anymore. I can't make out this name, but it says made in New York and it's priced at $30. Obviously it's like workout gear, kind of similar to Lululemon, and it's really well made. I don't know what brand that is. It's made in New York, so it must be important. This would look cute with like white tights or with black tights if you're working out outside. It's really nice.
It's in the back side, in the last.
It's really nice material too. I just never heard of that brand. Maybe we'll get it next time. Who knows? Blue jacket with a side kind of zip detail. But Tallulah doesn't sell for me. I've tried selling Tallulah and it didn't sell. I think Tallulah is only popular in like the more metropolitan cities like Toronto and stuff. I don't know. The applause, applause, applause. I live for the applause, applause, live for the applause, applause, live for the way that you feel and feel for me. The applause. Very Lady Gaga with the spikes. And yeah, Tallulah. So I was gonna get these Michael Kors jeans. It would have only been like $7, but it's a size 4 and it's in a popular skinny kind of style. And it has the MK right there. But I don't know. Jeans are kind of iffy. Pants in general are kind of iffy. We'll put it in the 3-4 section. I found it in the size 0 section, but it's cute. I don't know. We'll hide it. I don't know why we're hiding it. We're not gonna come back and get it anyway. Just on the Tallulah stuff, because Tina Thrifts on Instagram, I'll link her channel below. She said that it really doesn't, like, it sells well, but Babaton and Wolfred sell better. So we're going to pass on, we pass on those. And we just got the Tokidoki bag and a Lululemon top. Nancy's here and she wants to look at my Louis Vuitton backpack. You know she's a big Louis Vuitton whore. Sweetie.
Yeah, it looks smaller than I expected. It's not red.
No. And there's ink stains inside, but I tried to get rid of most of them.
Yeah, this could be a hassle.
Yeah. In and out all the time. If they do, I'm just going to ask them to put like a brown leather patch there or something similar. Like, I'll ask them what they can do. I'm probably not going to resell. I'll probably keep. Try it on. That's what it looks like on Nancy.
This is the last one?
Last
hole?
Yeah, that's the longest hole. Ooh. Actually, it looks good on you.
It looks short.
No, it's perfect size on you. On me, it looks small.
I'm so used to the backpack up to here. That's why. Yeah, it looks small. Well, you could put your essentials.
Oh yeah, like a purse, it'll work.
Yeah, there you go.
But not as a backpack.
Here. It doesn't even fit your phone.
I know.
An iPhone 5.
Or 4.
Go back.
That's a 2002 model, so.
Vintage battle. Not yet.
Vintage. Not vintage. Maybe. I guess people use vintage all the time if it's old.
But it's made in France. SP. Is it? Yes. Yeah. It is.
The only other wear, there's a little bit of cracking on the handle, like right there.
Well, that's, my thing is doesn't have that yet, but it started to crease like this.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's normal. But at least this is soft now.
Yeah.
Mine is still stiff. I don't use it that much. I use it in Punta Cana.
I'll use it for travel as my purse and then I'll have a carry-on. Look chic.
At least a buckle you could cross-body.
Yeah.
Bag or...
It looks like a Noe.
Looks like a when you... Shoulder bag.
Yeah.
Nice! Yeah, keep it.
Yeah, I'll keep it.
You're gonna loogie.
Yeah, I know. That's super cute, God. What? The clothes? Oh, great. Anyway, we're going to go over here to shoe repair. Nabal shoe repair. We're going to get our bags looked at. Kai, Kai, Kai. Raining like hell, my feet are wet. They're gonna smell so bad later, I'm not even kidding you.
See, this, you have to put something here in the top to match it up together.
Okay.
You have to put one in the bottom, one in the top, because if you don't put it, doesn't matter, you stitch it, it will be break. So you have to make a design nicely inside, outside, and it look nice.
Okay.
Anything else?
Nope, that's it.
Okay, for this bag, you're looking about at least 15 to 18 bucks.
Okay.
Okay?
For that one?
This is a little bit harder. Mm-hmm. See, this is, you have to open it from inside, and you have to go inside, and you have to build this one to hook inside, then after you sew it.
Okay.
So, maybe around 25, something like that.
Okay.
Okay?
And then it's
This one about 10 bucks.
Okay.
I'll give you a deal.
Okay.
Okay, this is 18 and 25 is 45, 55, and this one.
Oh, and if you can match the magnetic closure to this color, the brass?
Well, magnetic. This is, you have to be inside to open it up, inside, outside. After you hook it up, you open this one and you put this one inside. So it's go like this. You can't see it. You see the buckle, that's all. You see something like that, mm-hmm. exactly. Then after that, you have to get the female inside. So this is the whole thing about it.
Okay.
You know? I try to do it as much as look beauty.
Okay.
Yeah?
That's important.
Yeah, well, I know that's important. It's, you take this from here and you put it inside there.
Mm-hmm. So can we adhesive this down or no?
Yeah, it will be. See, it will be exactly like this, but you never use the buckle again.
Yes.
So when you drag it in like that.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Have you been open for business long here?
Which one?
Like, have you been here a long time?
10 years. I'm in this location.
Oh, okay.
And I used to be in the court of St. James, and we used to be in University. You remember University?
I grew up over there on David Street. So we dropped off my Danier bag, my Louis Vuitton bag, my Louis Vuitton backpack, a leather backpack, and a, whatchamacallit, we drop off. Okay. So we dropped off my Louis Vuitton backpack, my leather backpack, my Danier leather silver bag, and my suede crossbody. So he said it'll be ready by Monday, Tuesday, but I'm leaving for Minneapolis on Monday. So maybe I'll just leave later on Monday. We'll see. But yeah, so that's it. He doesn't have a ticket. Usually they give you a ticket just to confirm what you ordered or what you had, which is weird. So I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, yeah. That's a really good turnaround for 4 bags. He'll be done by Monday. Well, I guess today is Wednesday. So Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So it'll take him like 4 or 5 days. So $75 I paid for everything, which actually isn't that bad because the Louis Vuitton, I mean, that one is an investment. And then the suede bag I'm keeping too. So that one is an investment too. So yeah. For the Danier leather bag, it's not too bad. He wanted $10 to fix it, which is not bad. The bag only cost me, I think it was like $8. So plus $10 to fix it, $18. I think I can sell it for like $40 to $50. It's a really nice shape and color, and it's also Danier leather. So anyway, guys, so we just are coming from, where is it coming from? That place right there. I can barely see it. But yeah, so we're going to check out Value Village since we're in the area, and then that's it. There's the place. This is his car, I guess. I don't know. He showed me some of his work, and it was really nice. Like, he did his shoes and stuff. He's going, yeah, so I'm kind of excited. I want my bags before I leave for Minneapolis. maybe we'll just leave on Tuesday. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, guys. To be honest, I'm a little bit worried about my bag. I mean, I went over, I don't know if I caught the footage, but I went over it with him 3 times, exactly what I want done to the bag. What I'm worried about is that I told him to use adhesive to fix the peeling of the tip of the leather tab. I'm hoping he doesn't make the buckle unfunctional and then adhesive the whole buckle down, you know? I hope he doesn't do that. Because if he does, I'll be severely pissed. But I explained to him what I wanted done. I wanted the magnetic closure on it, and I want the tip of the tab adhesived. And I hope he understands that. You guys know I had such a bad experience. Not such a bad, but I mean a little bit of a bad experience with my Chanel bag with those cobblers. I don't know. It's just... a little bit kind of, you know, it's something I like a lot. I hope he does a good job on it. I told him I'll pay extra, make it look beautiful, make it everything match. He even matched the brass. He used actually a brass magnetic closure, like he found one in his shop. I asked for brass, so I mean, it could, maybe he just said it was brass and it's not, and it's just gold tone, but whatever. Anyway, I hope he does a good job, because I'll be pissed if he doesn't. Oh my god. And plus, you know, I paid $630 for that backpack. If something happens to it, I'll be mortified. I'm just gonna hope for the best that they actually do, like, the guy fixes my bag properly. Red Valley Village by Polo Park. We might go by Plato's, I'm not 100% sure yet. But we'll see. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, my God, I was so polite. I thought he was gonna be rude because he was, like, walking really fast, but who's that guy over there? He's really cute. But we're going to see what we can find here. Nothing over there. They don't seem to have good bags here lately. Ooh, that tall drink of water. What's this? Location. Cute. You guys see that really cute guy over there? Oh my god. I want him. Like, I want him now. That one right there. Did you guys see that? Do you see that? Do you see it? Do you? I don't know. This looks fake. That looks fake, isn't it? I would so date him. He can be my baby daddy. Okay. Smells so good too. Aw, turtle. Cute. Aw, purple rug. So I don't know what else we're going to find here. See that cute blonde guy too that walked by me? Yes. That one. Makes my loins tingle. Loins are tingling. Loins are tingle. Ooh. Is this an old school cell phone for the car? That is so cool. Okay, this one time I was seeing a guy, right? And I wanted to put, like, a hidden, like, baby monitor or, like, a hidden camera at the hotel that he was staying at, just so I can catch if he was cheating. And we weren't even dating. Like, how effed up is that? Look at the back of that head. Oof, it's my... I want to get, like, a close-up of him. Ooh, yeah. No. You know, I'm just wasting time so that we can get, like, a close-up of him. Right there. So. But I think we got it. Did we get it? Should I go over there and just ask him to marry me? Like, why can't you just marry me now? Like, what's your problem? All I want is to marry, settle down, and make love every day. I'm gonna go into Plato's. If I don't see anything, I'm probably gonna end the vlog. If I do see something, I will show you. But please give me positive vibes that the guy does a good job on my bags. The leather backpack, I might resell on eBay because it is just so good quality, and he emphasized it that it's good quality and really, you know, high end, even though it's like a no-name brand, but just the quality craftsmanship of it, you know? So I might list that on eBay for like $80 because I paid $2 and then I'm paying $20 to have it fixed. So basically I'm in it for $22, basically. So if I sell it for $80 plus shipping, I think that's a good deal. It's a huge backpack. The leather is amazing, and it's also convertible as a backpack or a tote. So that's That's a good, you know, it's multifunctional. So we're going to, I might list that on eBay or I might keep it for myself. I don't know, because it would make an awesome travel backpack. And then the Daniel Leather bag, I'm going to resell. I paid $8 for it. I think he's charging $10 to fix it. So I'm in it for $18. I hope to get between $40 to $50 because it's just really, really well made. The color is popping. And it's a style that's really popular with, you know, Daniel Leather, not their like dinky other styles. But that's what we're doing, the Daniel Leather. The Louis Vuitton, obviously, I'm keeping. And then the suede bag I'm keeping. So basically, out of all those, I'm really just selling one bag. Or I might sell the other one, so I'm not sure. But am I even parked correctly?